Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Myself Jay Taslima Nasreen. So today we are going to see the lesson Economically Useful Plants and Entrepreneur Botany for 12th standard. It's Biobotany, Economically Useful Plants and Entrepreneurial Botany. So under this we are going to see the topic Traditional System of Medicine. What is Traditional System of Medicine? As we are living in Tamil Nadu, we are well know about the Traditional System of Medicine, I think. So in the Traditional System of Medicine, there are two types, institutionalized and non-institutionalized. What is institutionalized? So institutionalized means nothing. It is documented, like a Siddha way of medicine, Ayurveda way of medicine, it's and all documented. So there will be written documents and proved herbs will be there. So that and all comes under institutionalized medicines. So the second one is non-institutionalized medicine. Non-institutionalized medicines means nothing. It is an oral medicine. So as we are in Tamil Nadu, we well know that if we take for stomach ache, we will be taking omam water and all. So it is a party medicine. So grandmother, our old grandmother's medicine, that's come under non-institutionalized medicines. It is a system of medicine. So in the traditional system of medicine, there are two types, institutionalized and non-institutionalized system of medicines. So here under this, we are going to study three system of medicine: Siddha system of medicine, Ayurvedic system of medicine and Fox system of medicine. So the first one is Siddha system of medicine. Siddha system comes under institutionalized medicines because it has a book which is documented, which was written by 18 Siddhas. Siddhas means the doctors of Siddhas. So in the earlier ancient days, they have written the 18 Siddhas together, joined and written and documented book, which is a book for Siddha medicines. So here this medicine is basically it trusts on Panchabhuta. We all know, right? Aibhutangal soluvomla Tamilla. So that is what Panchabhuta. Neer, Nilam, Kaatru. So that's it. They depend on that and the treatment is based on that. So okay, here also Vadam, Pittam, Kapam. So we all know these three things. We are familiar with these three things. So Siddha medicine is completely based on Vadam, Pittam and Kapam. So these three are very important in one medicinal life, one's health. So if there is any changes in these three, that will result in the health disorders. So next, so they have using plants, animal parts, marine products and minerals as their medicines. So Siddha medicine uses plants, animal parts, marine products and minerals as the medicines. So they are not using any preservatives. They are also making tablets, but they are not using any preservatives. They are using the minerals as a preservative. It gives long life shelf for the medicines. Clear, plants, animal parts, marine products and minerals. So here under Siddha medicine, 800 herbs have been identified and declared as a drugs for Siddha system of medicine. 800 herbs were declared as the proven drugs for Siddha medicines. Okay, so after Siddha, we are going to see about Ayurveda, Ayurvedic system of medicine. So here 18 Siddhas were written the book or no? Here it is Ayurvedic medicine is also the institutionalized medicines. It depends on Charaka, Sutra and Vekbada. They have written the book and they have documented. So it is also depends on Vadam, Pittam and Kapam. So Ayurveda is also based on Vadam, Pittam and Kapam. So if there is any alteration in these three, it may result in health disorders. So next is it also uses herbs and few animal parts only they have uses. They are not using marine products and all. Only herbs and few animal parts they were using. So here under this Ayurvedic pharmacopoeia, it is a field which approved 500 plants as a drug in Ayurvedic medicine. Here in Siddha, they have approved 800 medicines, 800 herbs. Here 500 plants have been approved for Ayurveda, which comes under the book Ayurvedic pharmacopoeia. It is a field. They have documented. Comes under institutionalized. So it is also Vadam, Pittam and Kapam. Based on this only Ayurvedic medicine also works. So after Siddha and Ayurveda, we are going to see about Fox system of medicine. Fox system is what? Pati Vaityam, grandmother's medicine. So they will be telling all the things in the oral form and we will be practicing daily. So food is medicine. That's it, Fox medicine. Here under Fox system, the forest department and ethnobiology department, so many departments have worked found in it, and they have approved 8,000 plants as the Fox system medicine. 8,000 plants which are available all over the world. So 8,000 plants have been approved under this system. So the people which practices Fox system is Irulas, Malayalis, Kurumbas, Tamilians. Everyone is practicing this system, because if we have a stomachache or indigestion problems, we will be asking our grandmothers, no? They will be suggesting omam water, so cumin waters and all. So that system is known as Fox system. So under traditional system, there are two types, institutionalized and non-institutionalized. So under this, we have seen Siddha, Ayurveda and Fox system of medicine. Here now we are going to see about different medicinal plants, the different medicinal plants we are using in our day-to-day life. See the medicinal plants. Here we are going to see two medicinal plants, which is Kila Nili and Nilavemba. So we are very familiar with these two herbs, I think. So Kila Nili, its botanical name is Phyllanthus amariensis, and it comes with the family Euphorbiaceae. Its family is Euphorbiaceae and its botanical name is Phyllanthus amariensis. Its origin is tropical American region. Its origin is tropical American region. It was planted in Tamil Nadu as well as India and many other tropical regions. So it is collected from moist places in plain. It cannot be harvested. It just will be collected. We will be collecting it from the moist places in plain regions. So here the Phyllanthus, not only the Phyllanthus amariensis. Here the Phyllanthus family, Medaraspinensis. Medaraspinensis is also has a very good medicinal properties, which is collected from non-forest areas. Okay, what is rich in Phyllanthus amariensis? What is the pigment which is rich in Phyllanthus amariensis? Phyllanthin, which is very useful, and it has medicinal properties in our human bodies. Here it is used to treat the diseases like jaundice. Jaundice is the major disease which affects the India, so it is used to treat the disease called jaundice. So here the researcher Tyagarajan, Dr. Tyagarajan, has undergone many researches, and he came out with the thing, the Phyllanthus amariensis extract. The extract of Phyllanthus amariensis is useful to treat hepatitis B virus. Hepatitis B is a dreadful virus, but the extract of Phyllanthus amariensis helps to treat the hepatitis B virus. Here it is Dr. Tyagarajan, he was scientifically proved this. Through the extract of Phyllanthus amariensis, hepatitis B virus will be treated. So after Kila Nili, we are going to see another herb called Nilavemba, another plant. So here its botanical name is Andrographis paniculata. Andrographis paniculata, it comes from a family called Acanthaceae. Okay, so it is called as king of bitters. It will be very bitter, so it is called as king of bitters. So it has a potent of hepatoprotective. What is hepatoprotective? It protects the liver. It safeguards the cells in the liver. So it acts as a potent hepatoprotective drug. So along with 8 herbs, not only Nilavemba, along with 8 herbs, which includes Nilavemba, they will prepare a liquid called Nilavemba Kudinir, which helps to fight against malaria and dengue. Malaria and dengue is a disease which is caused by mosquito. So it is useful to Nilavemba Kudinir is useful to prevent the disease from malaria and dengue. So we all know about Nilavemba Kudinir. Our government will be providing every year Nilavemba Kudinir in all the streets. So this is all about the medicinal properties, that is the medicinal plants Kila Nili and Nilavemba. So now we will be seeing the psychoactive drugs and all. So get tuned with our channel, you will get more educational videos. So enjoy the day. Thank you. Tata, bye bye. So please subscribe our channel and share.